Hi guys, this is Sarah. Welcome to my channel Biotin. This is a sincere effort taken to explain the concepts in the syllabus of Standard 10 Biology according to the Samachir Kalvi for your faster learning and easy understanding. I will be uploading videos in the upcoming weeks covering all the topics according to the pattern in your textbooks. My ultimate goal is to cover up all the portions and make it easy for you guys to have a happy learning. Before we get started, I request all of you to subscribe my channel and hit the bell button so that you will get my notifications as soon as my video gets uploaded. Thank you. Let's get started. Internal structure of dicot or dorsiventral leaf. The transverse section of mango leaf shows the following structure. The structures are seen in the picture given. Upper epidermis. It is the outermost layer made up of single-layered parenchyma cells without intercellular spaces. Outer wall of the cells are cuticularized. Stomata are less in number. Next we have lower epidermis. It is a single layer of parenchymatous cells with thin cuticle. Stomata are numerous. Chloroplasts are present in guard cells. It helps in the exchange of gases. The loss of water vapor is facilitated through the chamber. Next, we have mesophyll. The tissue present between the upper and lower epidermis is the mesophyll. It is differentiated into palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. Next, we move on to palisade parenchyma. It is found below the upper epidermis. The cells are elongated. Cells have more number of chloroplasts. The cells do not have intercellular spaces and they take part in photosynthesis. Next, we have spongy parenchyma. Spongy parenchyma are found below the palisade parenchyma tissue. Cells are almost spherical or oval or irregularly arranged. Cells have intercellular spaces and helps in gaseous exchange. Next, we move on to vascular bundle. Vascular bundle of midrib is larger. Vascular bundles are conjoined, collateral and closed. Each vascular bundle are surrounded by a sheet of parenchymatous cells called bundle sheet. Each vascular bundle consists of xylem lying towards the upper epidermis and phylum towards the lower epidermis. Next, we move on to internal structure of monocot or isobilateral leaf. The transverse section of monocot leaf shows the following structures. The structures are seen in the picture given. Epidermis. Monocot leaf has upper and lower epidermis. It is made up of parenchyma cells. Cuticle is present on the outer wall. Stomata are present on both upper and lower epidermis. Some cells of upper epidermis are large and thin-walled and are known as pulliform cells. Mesophyll. It is ground tissue present between both epidermal layers. Mesophyll is not differentiated into palisade and spongy parenchyma. Cells are irregularly arranged with intercellular spaces. Cells contain chloroplast. Next, we move on to vascular bundle. Large number of vascular bundles are present. Some are small and some are large. Each vascular bundle is surrounded by parenchymatous bundle sheet. Vascular bundles are conjoined, collateral and closed. Xylem is present towards the upper epidermis and phylum towards the lower epidermis. Next, we move on to table 12.4, which is the difference between dicot and monocot leaf. So the table is divided into two: dicot leaf and monocot leaf. Dicot is also known as dorsiventral leaf and monocot it is isobilateral leaf. In dicot leaf, the mesophyll is differentiated into palisade and spongy parenchyma, whereas in monocot, the mesophyll is not differentiated. With this, we come to the end of the session. Hope you guys understood it. In my next video, I will be explaining about plastids, structure and function of chloroplast and photosynthesis. If you have any doubts, please leave it in the comment section. Thank you. Happy learning!